The biggest challenge every food industry, food processing industry faces today is lack of advancement and innovation in its manufacturing practices. To bridge this upgradation gap, we at Neologic decided to present emerging food technical webinar series where we will talk about cost-effective automated solutions, application of top-notch machinery technology, current trends and future directions in food processing sectors, and much more. In third webinar of this series, today, we'll be talking about the new trends and technologies in fruit and vegetable industry. Few words about today's speaker, Mr. Shri Krishna Ozarkar. Welcome, Shri Krishna. Born in middle-class family in Nashik, he completed his entire education in Pune by completing mechanical engineering from Pune University in 1987. After spending few years in SKF, he joined Flavour and worked in project planning and execution in dairy and beverage sector of manufacturing department. He started his own entrepreneurial journey by starting his own firm in 1996 and eventually merged in business areas with Neurology. We have association, manufacturing association and partnership with Fenco Food Machinery Italy, and Shri Krishna is instrumental in this. He is a link between two companies. This association is for vegetable processing machinery. Having more than 30 years of industry experience and professionally hardcore technocrat, chart engineer and valuer, his interest are reading the books, Indian classical music and a lot of social work. So ladies and gentlemen, let me present our speaker today, Mr. Shri Krishna Ozarkar. Over to Shri.
Yes. Thank you, Rajendra, for a wonderful introduction. So as the name suggests, first of all, welcome once again for all the attendees and panelists and distinguished guests. Of course, we will be having a question answer session at the end of this particular webinar. So the topic today is new trends and technologies in fruits and vegetable industry. So here we start. So let us see what are the objectives and the discussion we are going to have in this particular session. So here we have why fruits and vegetables are to be processed, then earlier ways of processing, what is the current scenario in the industry, what are the upcoming trends in fruits and vegetable processing, and how you can add value or profitability to your processing line, existing processing line or incoming processing line. So let us understand first why fruits and vegetable processing. So global fruits and vegetable processing market is set to reach $346 billion, that's a huge amount, by 2022. And all of us know that year 2021 is International Year of Fruits and Vegetables. India is the second largest food producer in the world and is called fruit basket of the world because of its variety of fruits. But it contributes only 1% of processed fruits in the world. And that is due to very high wastage, which is of the tune of 30 to 35%. This makes Indian fruits and vegetable processing industry a sunrise sector of Indian economy. And we all know that this industry has been growing between double digits for last two decades now. So let us first understand what were the earlier ways of processing. So earlier ways, it was basically for preservation rather than more, we can call it as a processing. It was more of a preservation. So use of sugar syrup, salt syrup, or in some cases sulfiting has been very common in 17th century. Canning started in later parts of 18th century and got evolved over the years till today. And although many countries are now banning, especially for non-acidic products, the canning. The photographs you see on the right-hand side are the first canning machine models way back in 18th century are kept in a museum in London now. Canning is a general term which is applied to the process of packaging a food in a container and subjecting it to thermal process for the purpose of extending its useful life. An optimal thermal process which will destroy the pathogenic bacteria, kill or control the spoilage organisms present, and have minimal impact on the nutritional and physical qualities of the food. So, evolvement of canning industries. On the right hand side, you see most of you who could have been earlier already part of food processing industry or must have visited. So this is a typical scenario even till last 10 years back of the canning industry, a huge pile of cans kept one after one over the other. And that is after it is processed. So the earlier way or the older way of canning was hot filling in the cans, then turning it at 180 degrees, keeping it for manual hot retorting in a basket, and again cooling it manually by keeping it in a water bath by dipping that complete basket. So this is what traditional way, few of industries are still running in the same way, but is the traditional way for last, I will say around five decades now. On the left hand side, you can see a machine, which is what we call as a linear tunnel. Nowadays, linear tunnels are also used for cans, bottles, pouches, jars, and a lot of many things. So this is the evolvement of the canning line. So instead of dipping it into manual retorts or dipping it into hot retorts or a cold bath, this is becomes a separate complete linear tunnel where we can have a hot section, we can have a cold section. And this helps that particular pasteurization cycle to be completed. So this is what we see right now. But there are also some limitations in the canning process. So let us try to understand. The old way of completely manual it was, and it was not because it spilled a lot of water on the ground, because when the beans were taken out from the hot bath or cold bath, there was all the, everything was done. It did not have any temperature control, which is very essential when you are doing any food production, typically for on a large scale, even at home. And this led to improper heating on many occasions, leading into not having good shelf life. The entire process was as it involved a lot of laborious work, leading to a lot of injuries and stoppage of work. Even after involvement of linear tunnel, so-called mechanization, the energy consumption was so high and it occupied so much space on the processing floor that people were looking for alternative or looking for better solution from that. So let us understand what is the current scenario for this particular industry of fruit pulps or purees or vegetable purees. So the introduction of bulk aseptic packing. So it was around 1970 when the bulk aseptic packing with the sprouted pouch was introduced to world. It took almost 25 years. That is in 1995, we started getting the aseptic bulk packaging in India. And over the years, this technology again has evolved to a great extent. Some most distinguishing advantages of aseptic system are shelf stable, no refrigeration required, very important aspect. Extended freshness and longer shelf life, which can be up to 24 months. No preservatives are required for this shelf life. Optimal flavor, texture, and nutrient retention because of the process. It eliminates costs, logistics, and energy used in the cold chain. So let us understand the basics of bulk aseptic packing. So the pulp, puree, paste, or concentrates are sterilized in aseptic sterilizer. Bulk aseptic bags of 220 kg or 1000 kg, which are pre-sterilized with gamma rays, are used for filling of this product in sterile environment. When I say sterile, that means there is no contact of oxygen or atmosphere to maintain that aseptic. And based on the aseptic sterilizer capacity, the aseptic filler can be single head or double head. The features of filling of aseptic, bulk aseptic, can be also included with the filling facility for sample bags, which is 3 kg. And we have attachments nowadays with small backpacking, which can be of 3 kg, 5 kg, 10 kg, or 20 kg. These are some typical pictures of aseptic sterilizer. You can see the sterilizer with tube-in-tube model. Typically, these tube-in-tube models can be 2-tube, 3-tube, or 4-tube, depending on the product, depending on the viscosity, depending on the application. We also have something called as a piston pump, which is to create a positive pressure, which is over pressure than the media pressure, whether it is heating or cooling. We have a hot water chamber over here. We have a hot water circuit with the steam control valves, bypass valves. So everything is there to maintain the aseptic. Again, you can see another picture over here. As I said, the aseptic fillers can be of different capacity. This is a typical single-head aseptic filler. And this is the older version of double-head aseptic filler. And then we have aseptic filler in which we can have one head filling 220 kg and one head filling 1000 kg, where it is called as a bag-in bin or bag-in box. And then we also have bag-in drum. So 220 kgs. In India, we do not have many companies who are using 1000 kg packs, but in China and southern parts of America or South America, they're using 1000 kg bags. The consumption is very, very high. Another picture of double-head aseptic filler. Here what we see is it's a bigger double-head aseptic filler than what we have seen earlier, because it is having a rotating platform. So it is having a platform which can hold a pallet with four drums of aseptic. The head actually comes under one particular drum. After one drum is filled, the complete pallet revolves, it goes to the second drum, then again the pallet revolves, it goes to the third drum and the fourth one. Once all the four drums are filled, the entire pallet is then moved next to the station where they are stored. On the right hand side, we can see something what we monoblock. Monoblock system has been typically developed for two markets in the world, that is India and Brazil, where they had some space constraint and where they also wanted to maintain or operate the filler as well as sterilizer from the same room. So this is a typical example of monoblock, which is used in India as well as in Brazil. So what we saw, the aseptic bulk filling, the latest trend in the industry is of a small bag-in box, and which can be for 3 kg, 5 kg, 10 kg, 20 kg bags. What you see on the left-hand side is a single-head aseptic filling machine, what we call as a web filler, where the bags are attached to one another like sachets. So these bags are attached to one another and the machine detaches it from the earlier web. And these are typically used for the institutional use of different products. On the right hand side, you see a double-head aseptic filler. Again, it is bag in box for small bags, 3 kg, 5 kg, 10 kg, and 20 kg. Again, at the bottom, you can see where the bags are being fed. And we also have aseptic tank in both the cases, where the product which is under filling after it is going to the second head, if there is a time lag in between, the product goes back to the aseptic tank. So these are the latest trends where a lot of people are asking for the bag-in-box filler, especially 10 kg and 20 kg. These are the very popular models nowadays. But of course, the machine has facility to fill right from 3, 5, 10, 20. But we cannot fill 220 kg over here. But in case we have 220 kg filler, we can use the attachment and put small bags on that. Another solution which has evolved over the years, which has come as an alternative apart from aseptic, is a spiral solution. Of course, this aseptic solution has a shelf life of 24 months. The spiral solutions will have different life because the process itself is different. In spirals, we have spiral heaters, spiral pasteurizers, spiral coolers, or spiral freezers. And over the years, like I mentioned, the spiral solution was developed as an upgrade to to canning of linear tunnels. We saw a linear tunnel, a typical linear tunnel, which we saw normally say for 2 tons or 3 tons of pulp or cans or pouches will be around 2 meters by 25 meters or 2 meters by 20 meters. So it is going to occupy that much space, and the same machine can be occupied in 3 meters by 3 meter space or 3 meter diameter space when it is used as a spiral, because we are using the vertical space and you can see the number of tiers which is being used instead of the linear space. And this has now become an integral part of food processing solutions. So main advantages of this particular system are proper temperature control. I can completely control the temperature of the product, whether it is a bare product or whether it is a packed product. These are energy saving. So the complete spiral belt hardly requires a 3 HP or 4 HP motor, although the complete belt is of almost 300 meters long. Space saving, as I mentioned, the entire linear tunnel, which was occupying, say, 2.5 meters by 25 meters, is actually being occupied in 4 meters by 4 meter space. More hygienic solution, as there is no water spillage coming out, no cans, no retorts, no baskets taken out. So everything is within the machine. The spiral has already a tank beneath it, and all the water which is being sprayed on the pouches, cans or jars is collected at the bottom and then refiltered and recirculated with the heat exchanger. It has typically very low water consumption, so it is very attractive in terms of operational cost. Low maintenance cost, because the machine is made in such a sturdy way that it requires minimum maintenance. And as I said, it is very operationally cost efficient. A typical example of a Kisan pouch, if I cool it, I'm just giving you example, a ketchup pouch, any ketchup pouch, 1 kg pouch, typically is cooled in a linear tunnel in a spiral cooler. The spiral cooler cooling operational cost will be almost 1/3. And it has got wide application range. We will see what are the applications for spirals. So understand application. So it is not just fruit purees, fruit or juices or pulps or concentrate. It can be for fried items which are cooled by air. So it can be samosa, it can be bakarwadi, it can be shev, or it can be farsan. Then bakery items like breads, rusk, cakes, or biscuits. And we have hot filled pulps, purees, food, sauces, ketchups, curries, gravies, and a lot of RTE items which are being cooled over there. It has also been used for batter cooling. So we have recently supplied a spiral cooler to cool batter to a typical temperature which is required. And it is also used in dairy products like paneer, cheese, or ice cream. So for ice cream, it can be for ice cream cooling, ice cream hardening, or ice cream freezing. Spirals are also used for cooling of meat, fish, poultry items, or it can be only for cooling, or it can be only for freezing as well. So this is about spiral, the alternative or the latest technology in terms of preservation of food or increasing the shelf life. What you see over here is a machine which is typically having a divider aligner. So this particular first machine in the forefront is going to divide the pouches from 1/3. So the machine, filling machine releases one pouch. This converts 1/3, 1/2, depending on what kind of configuration is required. Then we have hot hold, which is going to hold. So if my filling temperature is 92, this will hold 92 for 30 seconds, 20 seconds, 1 minute, depending on what is the product, and then the length will be changing. It has got a temperature control as well. And then it goes for cooling in a spiral cooler. So entry from the bottom, exit from the top. We almost have 18 to 20 spiral tiers over here to cool down that particular product from 95 degrees to 35 degrees. This is machine used in Heinz, Nestle, Hindustan Unilever, all these people are using these kind of machines. So again, it is not only for cooling, it can be pasteurizing as well as cooling. So on the left hand side, you can see photo of heating as well as cooling spirals. On the right hand side, same machine during the trials in the workshop. It has got also the dryer, online dryer, because the pouches which are coming out from the cooler carry a lot of moisture or a lot of water droplets, which need to be dried off immediately because there is online packing, secondary packing going on. Another typical example of air cooling of sachet or pouches. This particular example is from Nestle plant using three different outlets for the three different products. For bread, as I mentioned, bread or cakes or rusk, this can be applied as well. And a lot of companies are still using this, including Britannia. Spiral hardeners or freezers, example, again, space saving, energy saving. It can be used for cups, it can be used for cones, it can be used for bulk packs of 1 liter, 2 liter, or even 4 liters. This is another product which has evolved over the years. So what you see over the machine, what we call as a portion product or easy cube. So this converts all leafy vegetables like spinach or coriander into cubes. So all of us know that if I cut leafy vegetables, we lose the nutrient values. And cubes, we can compact them into back into the cubes.
Krishna, yes. There was a bandwidth problem. Can you repeat the last sentence, please?
Yes. So I was saying that this can be, we all know that nutrient value in the leafy vegetables is in their leaves. So here we do not cut the leaves. We only compact them. And the compacting, while compacting is being done, the juice which is coming out is again injected back into the cubes or burgers or whatever the shape is. And this can be from 10 gram, 15 gram, 50 gram, even up to 50, 100 gram as well. Another need of the hour, smaller or pre-assembled modular processing units. So we, having experienced of Indian agri sector, a lot of you must have understood that the need of today is a smaller processing units near the fruits and vegetable cultivation area. So Neologic, along with their Italian partner Fenco, are developing these smaller or pre-assembled processing units. Advantages of such smaller pre-assembled processing units are, they require much less space because they are pre-assembled and on modules. They're easy to install, operate, and maintain. Can cater smaller capacities, 1 tons or 3 tons. Can be expanded into additional modules in future. So typical fruit processing lines can be 6 tons, 10 tons, even 20 tons. And in China, we have lines of 60 tons as well. But this particular can cater also 1 ton or 3 tons. These are budget friendly, hygienic design with effective CIP. This is a typical example of modular puree sterilizer for tomato. The capacity is 1 ton. So it is like a plug and play machine. Another area which we would like to cover in the new trends of food processing or vegetable processing is IoT-based plant operations and monitoring. So all of us know what is IoT, Internet of Things, being used to operate or monitor, and what are the advantages or what are the particular aspects of this particular system, that is implementation, lower implementation cost, traceability. I can trace what has happened in one particular batch, what was the temperature at that time. Real-time management of critical systems. This is also very important. So you don't have to do any postmortem. It can then do a real-time management. Critical information on mobile platform. So everything can be controlled from mobile or your handheld devices. automated work management systems, and product models flexibility. So we can have flexibility with the product models for the IoT-based operations and monitoring. Again, what are the advantages? Increased plant utilization and efficiency. I can very well know if my steam consumption is getting more than what is it desired to be. I can do some work over there. I can do same thing in the product. Changeover downtime is reduced. Transparency and flexibility in production. So you can share this data with your end customer if he asks. Energy and resource efficiency, as I said, if I understand where I'm spending more energy, I can very well attend that. Vertical integration is possible. And raw material consumption, mass balance, everything can be monitored. Okay, so let us also have a look at another aspect, which are the emerging technologies and the future trends in this particular area. We are just going to take overview because these technologies are yet to be proven. These are under testing. There will take a couple of years for testing. So some of the classical emerging technologies, which are as follows. Ozone treatment. Some companies have already started using this. Ultraviolet and membrane processing. We at Neologic have also started working on membrane processing. Enzymatic macration. And freeze concentration. We also have something which is called HPP. We have some juices right now available in the market. So these typical examples of HPP are used especially where you want to retain color and flavor. And these are very highly priced products. There are limitations also. There is also something called as PEFP, which is pulse electric field processing. Very effective for juice processing. Then we have something called as MTAS, microwave thermal assisted sterilization. It's actually MATS, not MTAS. So microwave thermal assisted sterilization. And the application in typically USA is for army. So they are actually giving all the whole meal trays for the microwave treatment, sterilization treatment, and soldiers are getting it like a home food. Another aspect which we should be covering here is adding profitability to your processing line. As we grow or as the technology is growing, we should always add profitability to our processing line. And how we increase our profitability? By increasing the product recovery. So you increase your product recovery and you increase your profitability. So fruit and vegetable plant range normally from 1000 kg or 20,000 kg in India. Across the globe, as I mentioned, in China, we have some lines going up to 60,000 kg. So even 0.5% on 1% change in recovery of the product or the puree or whatever product recovery we are going to have is going to result into additional product of lakhs of rupees every day. Over the year, it will be in crores. So the use of latest technologies, trade tricks, use of new effective processes, can make this possible without actually compromising on the product quality, texture, aroma, and flavor. And a lot of companies also approach us for this particular aspect of increasing their product recovery. Again, use of picking systems, which has helped to recover the product lost in pipelines. There are plants where the pipelines are thousands and thousands of meters. And at the end of the cycle, if I'm going to just flush that product completely, I'm going to lose that much volume. So picking systems are also used for recovering that lost product. Another aspect which we should be covering because of the evolvement of technology is converting a single fruit plant into multi-fruit plant. So conventionally, the tradition has been the fruit processing plant of medium or higher capacities, maybe 3 tons, 5 tons, 6 tons, 10 tons, 12 tons. Over the years, with the increased cost of land, energy, construction, utilities, the processors are now converting their single fruit processing plant into multi-fruit processing plant. And the typical examples lie in typical areas of Chittoor or Krishnagiri. So people only put the plant for mango And now they are converting those mango plants into mango, guava, papaya, or other fruits. With little addition or investment or bypassing some of the machines, a single fruit line can be converted into multi-fruit processing line, provided these are from the same horticultural family. Like I mentioned, mango, this line can process guava, this line can process papaya, tomato, sapota, and few other fruits as well. The seasons of all these fruits are different, and we are processing the processing variety of the fruits or vegetable, which come in every different season or different months. And this results into plant being utilized for far more number of days. So we all know that mango, it can start maybe in April or May or June, depending on the location, Maharashtra or South India or Gujarat. And then that plant will be running maybe for 60 days, 75 days, or at the most 90 days. But the same plant, if I'm converting into multi-fruit plant, can run for guava, which is in different season, can run for papaya, again for different season, and can also process tomato, again different season, or support a chiku. And all this from 60 days, 75 days of processing, this plant, some of the plants we have examples, are running now 210 days, 230, 240 days out of 365 days. So that is giving a better return of investment for all the processes. So let us take a quick recap of what we have learned. Why fruits and vegetable processing? First of all, we are the second largest producer in the world, but we only contribute to 1% of processing. So processing is a must so that we are able to utilize all this second largest name for our old country, for exports, and for the benefit of the complete industry. We also understood the earlier ways of processing, whether it is using of sugar syrup, using of salt syrup, or using of sulfites in some cases, or canning, typical canning lines of old times. Then the evolvement of linear tunnels for cans, which were subsequently also used for different products. And these linear tunnels used lesser energy, they were more hygienic, they were less messy in terms of using of earlier ways. So that changed to linear tunnel. Over the years, the linear tunnel converted into two aspects. It was aseptic for the bulk packing, for the bag-in-box packing as well, which is giving the shelf life of 24 months, which is very good. So whatever juice drinks we are drinking are prepared from those aseptic bags of shelf life of 24 months. And the second aspect, which we also understood, is cooling of pouches, cooling of jars, cooling of cans in the spirals, which also have got a shelf life of maybe 1 year or 1.5 years, depending on what kind of product it is and how you are filling it. So that is the change from the earlier canning industry to spiral cooling or aseptic cooling. We also understood the upcoming trends, which are like high pressure processing or pulse electric field processing, and microwave thermal treatment, sterilization, and all this. So these are the upcoming trends. Of course, they will take some time to get established, some time to actually have all the pros and cons, what are the side effects, what is the costing of that particular aspect. So it will take some years to understand and develop or run into that. And we also understood on adding profitability of your processing line, how to add profitability by converting a single fruit processing line into multi-fruit processing line. We also understood how to use all the end product without losing, or how to recover that particular product recovery, how to increase your recovery of the product, yield of the product, so that your bottom line is increased by using all this. So this is the typical recap of what we have particularly gone through.
Another question on spiral heaters: how we can ensure temperature of inside product in spiral heaters?
So there are specific instruments which are checking the temperature of the product inside, and these are controlling my water temperature or hot water or steam, whatever I'm going to do. So there are typical temperature controls, and the process is normally established prior to actual production starting. Once that process is established, the parameters do not change.
Okay. Another question from Manjiri Rane. I'm working in an ice cream industry. I'm looking for custard apple processing method in order to increase its shelf life and to reduce its microbial load. Can we provide the solution?
Yes, definitely we can provide. So what we can do is take their number or their contact details, and we will be talking to them in person, understanding their requirement in detail, and try to help them for their solution.
Another question from Dr. Dhruv Jyal. Which companies are using spiral applications right now?
So there are world leaders or the brand names. If you would like to understand the brand names, hence Nestle, Hindustan Unilever, and a lot of even smaller players are also using spiral technologies. And this is not only for the...
Another question from Mr. Suryakant Reddy. Spiral cooling in dairy industry and its significance.
Yes. So as I mentioned, the spiral cooler in dairy can be used for cooling of paneer. It can be used for cooling of cheese. And of course, the ice cream, the freezing of ice cream or the hardening of ice cream. And the applications are already being used by the industry. So spiral freezers are very popular in comparison with the hardening tunnels. Spiral coolers for cheese as well as for the paneer are already being used by the industry leaders right now.
Another question from Mr. Kiran. How can we process pre-pasteurized olives or preserved olives into value-added food like stuffed olives in India?
Yes. So we need to ask them what kind of product they are looking for. So we have something called as olive oil. We also have some process done on the olives as well. And there are plants where we have also supplied few machines, which can be given example or which we can discuss with them in person or on the Zoom call or other way.
Another question from Mr. Kiran Paithankar. Are there solutions from Neologic for raw fruits and vegetable handling and processing into beverage and ready-to-eat packs?
Yes. So Paithankar sir, yes, definitely we do have solutions for completely converting the raw fruits into beverage as well as purees, whatever is the requirement. So we have already number of references for that. And definitely we will get in touch with you. We already have your contact details.
Another question from Manshi Tomar. Which fruits and vegetables are most apt for processing industry as per recent times?
Oh, so see, this depends on which kind of area you're going to put a plant. Typically, the processed fruits are mango, banana, tomato, guava, papaya, apples. We also have then pears, even amla. So there are a lot of fruits and vegetables which are processed for the processing variety, of course. And this will depend on what kind of capacity we are looking for, what is the end use we are going to require, whether we are requiring powder, whether we are requiring puree, whether we are requiring juice, or whether we are going for concentrates or pastes. So depending on what kind of product and what kind of fruit we are having ample, because all these plants normally run in a season. If I'm running a plant in a season, I should have ample capacity to run it because I'm having the limited resources for that particular time. So maybe 2 months, maybe 1 month, or maybe 3 months. And then I should be fully utilizing around the clock, so maybe 20 hours running a day, every day. I should be able to utilize that plant. So let us understand which products you are talking about, which is the area you are talking about, and what is the end product we would like to convert into.
Next question is from Mr. David. Export packing of vegetables results with high trimming waste, such as cabbage and other leafy greens. Interested in cube compressing of leafy trimmings, can we get help from Neologic on this particular technology?
Sure, sure. So apart from portioning products, we also have a machine for the fresh cut vegetables and salads. So that portions also is different, although we have not put it as a part of this particular presentation. So in both the cases, we can definitely help you, Mr. David.
Okay, next question is from Mr. Nilesh Jalamkar. Any specific process which retain nutritional value in fruits and vegetables?
Nilesh sir, definitely we like to understand which fruit you are talking about and what kind of the end product we are going to process. So based on these two particular aspects, we will be definitely able to help you to retain the nutritional values.
Next question is from Vanshi. What is the role of hot holders in spiral solution?
Yes, good question, Mansi. So basically, when I'm filling in a pouch, which is not an aseptic pouch, aseptic bag or small bag, I'm filling inside that pouch and that is filling at hot temperature, maybe it is 90 degrees or 92 degrees. I need to hold it, what we call as a pasteurization process. So heating and holding completes the pasteurization process. So if I'm not holding it, the product may not have the desired shelf life. Again, this depends on the product. Some products are require hot holding. Some products do not require hot holding. Just filling, hot holding, just filling and cooling is also okay. So again, this will depend on the product and the process what we are going to establish.
Okay, the next question is from Mr. Dhruv. Can latest technologies be compared to UHT technology?
This can be compared. See, the technology, UHT technology is completely different. The technologies what we discussed over here is completely different. Again, I will come back to the same point. What we are using for the UHT technology. So what is that? So whether it is a milk, what other products we are going to process. So that will depend and that will determine what is more effective to process that particular aspect.
Okay, next question is from Mr. Dholakia. Can we go for spiral solutions for tamarind puree and concentrate?
Yes. So Mr. Dholakia, as we were discussing some time back, that is going to be a part of solution which we are going to discuss and they are definitely going to be effective. In fact, at some places, this is being already used.
There are a few questions about ozone technology. People would like to know more about ozone technology.
Yes. So, but ozone technology itself is a different topic or vast subject. So I would like to understand the person's contact details and what we can do. Our team can get in touch with them and try to have a Microsoft Teams or Zoom call to explain, because it requires say at least about 8 to 10 slides to explain that particular technology.
Okay, sir, noted.
Yeah.
Another question is from Mr. Atul Bagade. Can we go for aseptic custard apple in process spiral technology?
Atul, we need to understand what kind of capacity you are looking for and what is the kind of packing, whether it is a small pack or big pack, and why you require that kind of shelf life.
Yeah, Mansi Tomar is asking about the role of hot holder in spiral solution.
Yes, I just answered that. If you want, I can repeat that. So Mansi, as I mentioned, when I'm filling the product in the pouch, it is just hot filling. Some products require as a part of their process, hot holding. So when I'm doing pasteurization cycle, I'm pasteurizing, that is heating up to a certain temperature, holding it for a certain number of seconds or number of minutes, depending on the product, depending on the flow rate again. So then the pasteurization is complete. So that is the role of hot holder for that particular product. So the photograph which we saw, that was for some tomato pouches, tomato puree pouches, where they were using this particular hot holding for the, we have some companies in India as well who are doing that hot holding in the spirals.
So we have one more interesting question from Mr. Harbola. Is there any method or procedure to check the exact ripening stage of a fruit that is ready for processing and can give high yields?
Yes. So Mr. Harbola, there are technologies to cover this. And we have something called as a ripening chamber where temperature, moisture, everything are controlled. And these are typically monitored for all the ripeness of the fruits. And that is how over the years, we were doing the conventional ripening by keeping the mangoes or other fruits or even papaya. Papaya used to be kept in a newspaper ripening. So newspaper covering, and then they were ripened by conventional methods. But over the years, people have developed these technologies by maintaining the ripening chambers with typical temperatures, with typical moisture control. And we also have other gases which are used to typically ripen them to get a particular yield.
Mohan Kumar is asking, what is the cost of modular processing unit and ROI? And how to start the fruit processing business in my local area?
Yes. So Mohan Kumar, we need to understand which area you are located and which is the fruit or vegetable you are trying to process, whether it is mango, guava, papaya, tomato. And then we can actually suggest you what will be the correct capacity to process this, because a very low capacity will not give you a correct return on investment. Very high capacity also may not give. So you need to have what we call as a threshold capacity. So determination of threshold capacity of any particular processing plant is also very important, because my utilities, my energy consumptions are divided over that particular aspect. So that we need to understand, and then we can definitely suggest you which is the typical capacity in which fruits you can process in your particular area.
Suryakant is asking about the tomato processing. What will be the low cost model suitable for small scale industry in Andhra?
Andhra, okay. So to manufacture, we can manufacture right from say 500 kgs per hour. And as I said, the biggest line we have supplied is 60,000 kgs per hour. But our observation or our experience in this particular field shows that if we are having say 3 tons per hour or 2 tons per hour, I'm talking about raw tomato input, because tomato, we know if I'm converting tomato to tomato paste, it goes, the yield is 1/6 or 16% only. So I'm giving 6 kgs of tomato, I'm getting 1 kg of tomato paste. So the minimum size should not be less than 3 tons per hour, because then I'm going to get 500 kgs of tomato paste as output. As I said, it is not that we cannot make machine below that. We can definitely make machine below that as well. But this is going to cost you more in terms of conversion of 1 kg of tomato paste rather than the other people. If someone is using 6-ton line, someone is using 10-ton line, and their conversion cost is say rupees 15, then your conversion cost could be 18 or 19 rupees. So that is going to affect your bottom line when you are competing in the market. So let us try to understand the capacities, your budget limits, and then we will try to suggest you the threshold capacity for your particular tomatoes or tomato processing in your particular area.
Yeah. Vilas Patil is asking, you know, coconut water, can we supply the coconut water processing line?
Yes, Vilasji, thank you for your question. You are already well versed with a lot of technologies, being the part of so industry for so many years. And just to tell you that we have those technologies, Fenco has those technologies. We also have our lot of senior management, which is ex-Tetra Pak, who have dealt with these particular products in their tenure of Tetra Pak. So definitely we can discuss and take it with you, sir.
We can take one last question. The question is from Mr. Kiran Dhameja. How can we retain moisture of breads without getting them too dry pre-packaging or having moisture that will get into molding, especially Arabic breads like hoops or pita breads?
Yes. So very, very good and nice question, sir. I appreciate that. This is a very typical and critical application where the airflow of the fans which are going to use for the cooling or maintaining the moisture in the controlled atmosphere are going to play a major role. And we have done a lot of work in this. Our partners in Italy have also done a lot of work in this. And because of our experience, we can definitely help you to retain the moisture to a certain level, not very high, not very low, to the desired level, I can say, which will give the effective cooling or effective dryness to the bread.
Nikhil, you need to answer about this now, the availability of this video webinar.
This webinar on official channel of Neurologic Engineers, and tomorrow everyone will get the link of this particular webinar.
Nikhil, I think we can take one or two more questions. It's 5 o'clock. Maybe we can take one or two if there are. Otherwise, we can, or you can announce the next upcoming webinars as well.
Okay.
Have we missed any of the questions?
One minute. I'm screening through the question answers section.
Or you can ask people to again post.
One more question. Dr. Dhruv has asked. No? Which are the companies who are using these spiral applications?
As I mentioned, this is used by lot many companies. Just to tell you the brand name, I don't know from which area you are, sir, but this is being used by Haynes, this is being used by Nestle, this is being used by Hindustan Unilever. If you are from Pune, even the spiral coolers are also used by Chitale Group. Spiral coolers are used by ice cream people like Baskin Robbins and other companies. Spiral coolers are also used by Amul. So a lot of people are already using this technology.
I'm not sure if this question is taken. This is Janvi Meru is asking whether aseptic bulk filler can be used for the...
Aseptic bulk filler can be used for?
Beverage.
Aseptic bulk filler, it can be used. That is not that it cannot be used. But why you are requiring the aseptic bulk packing for the beverage? Because the basic purpose of aseptic bulk packing is to convert it into smaller units or retail packs. I think there is another question asked by Vilas Patil, sir. Can you supply a ripe banana peeling machine? Yes, sir. We do have, and we'll be definitely talking with you about that particular machine. There is another question from Mr. Chandrasekhar Reddy, Devi Reddy. He's asking, do you have any solution for solid waste from fruits and vegetable processing unit? Yes, we do definitely have, but that is a different topic altogether, which is not a part of our today's webinar, but definitely we do have solutions for that as well.
So we have one more question about spiral solution. Up to what minus temperature we can achieve in spirals?
Minus 40.
I think Sri Krishna has tried to answer most of the questions. Maybe you know there are maybe more some more questions are there, but I will request participant to maybe contact him separately. So that he will definitely.
They can take a screenshot of the screen right now. So they can write to us, they can call our marketing person.
And we'll be very happy to answer you.
Sure.